that have taken place.
Thank you, Mr. Oriole. Any members of the board have any questions of this witness?
Could you point out where the sign is in that? I'm just not really sure.
Sure.
So it's on a pole?
Right, it's on the pole. It's the sign that goes on the street. It is the pole. That's why when you see this, the second one, the gentleman's carrying it on his shoulder, catty corner.
Okay.
Again, I have the video, which is more clear. This is just a snapshot of the video.
I understand.
Mr. Morris, do you have any questions of this?
Yes, I do. I'll try to be very brief. It's extensive and a lot of exhibits here, and I don't want to prolong this unnecessarily, but there's some things I would like to understand. Your exhibit 6, mm-hmm. that's a very extensive report that goes back to the year 2010,
mm-hmm.
and it goes all the way up to 2016.
Mm-hmm.
Who made this report?
The police department.
And how did you get this in the police department?
I went and asked for a copy of it.
Did you assist in making any information available to the police?
No. Oh, did I assist in the whole thing? But I don't understand what you're saying.
Well, this is a period of almost 6 years.
Mm-hmm.
So you were monitoring the jet set for over 6 years?
No, I lived there. So any activity, anything that happens in the neighborhood, it's like, let me ask you a question.
No, just answer his question.
No.
Okay. Now, do you have any other witnesses here tonight?
Yes.
And the one young lady that is here left.
Mm-hmm.
Any other witnesses?
Yes.
Who are they?
Mr. Juan standing sitting right there. Oh, I'm sorry. And Ms. Kathy.
Now, this is a very extensive investigation you conducted in the Jet Set restaurant over a period of 6 years. What other bars or restaurants in the city of Reading that you made similar inspections of?
None.
None. So this is one bar, one restaurant across the street that you made, okay, investigation.
No, I didn't make an investigation.
When you say investigation, what do you mean,
I'm
sir?
Sorry.
He's not a police officer, so
it even worse, Mr. Chairman.
No, I'm the solicitor, number one. Number two, when you use words like investigate, you have to explain what you mean by investigation to him, because it's a police term, it's a different term. So what
you don't understand the term investigate?
I understand that, but I'm not an investigator or investigating them. I'm just putting out facts of things that have happened while I've been there, while I've been sitting at my front step, while I've been sleeping in my bed and hear pow 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 and open up my window and look out and see people running and people scattering all over the place. When I hear horns blowing like crazy, and again, I'm trying to sleep, it's 2 o'clock in the morning, or whatever, open up my window, of course. Tell me that you are not going to observe and be observant of something that's happening in your community if you hear shots, if you hear people screaming, if you hear cars squeaking, if you hear horns blowing. It's not investigation. That's part of what you, as a human being, you do. You observe what's going on in your community, what's going on in front of your house.
Well, over this period of 6 years then, what type of business are you in?
What type of business am I
in?
I work for a halfway house.
And that halfway house is your residence, is that correct?
No, it's not. I have my own residence.
Okay, well, who else is in that residence?
My wife, my daughter.
Okay. And what about the halfway house?
Mm-hmm.
Where's the halfway house located?
Right next door.
Right next door.
Mm-hmm.
And the halfway house consists of whom?
Consists of residents, people who come out of prison.
People that
come out of prison.
Okay. And over a period of 6 years, these people came and go, were prisoners?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes. Could you try to say yes or no?
Yes.
Thanks.
Were any one of those prisoners available here tonight to corroborate your testimony?
No.
Why?
They don't need to be here.
They don't need to be here?
Well, I mean, some of them are, I don't know where they're at as far as what the timing is concerned. I didn't feel deemed necessary to have to bring him here.
I see. Now, the police officer, the captain who testified mm-hmm. here, presented a black book.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and how many calls have you made to the police department concerning the Jet Set restaurant?
I have no idea.
Well, can you give it a proxy?
I can't tell you, and I didn't investigate.
Okay.
Or
did you make any calls? Did you make any calls?
Log down any particular, thing like that. What I did was, sir, when an incident happened, and I saw it, and I saw that it warranted me calling the police, I would call them. I wouldn't just get up out my window, gee, let me just call the police. I had no idea that this even existed.
Okay. Well, how did you come to bring it here tonight?
How did I bring it here?
Yeah.
Because someone told me about it.
Who?
I'd rather remain that confidential.
Was it a police officer?
I'd rather remain confidential regarding it.
So you're presenting a report that you don't know the source of?
That I have no source of?
No, he said the report came from the police department, that he came up here and got it from the police department.
Right.
Okay. Now, have you any other bars in the city or restaurants that you made the same effort?
No.
Why?
Because they're not in front of my house, and I don't have, they haven't influenced the community and those that live in that block like Jesset has.
Now, you presented a report that goes back to 2010 that you went to the police department, they accommodated you giving all these incidents. Is that
mm-hmm.
correct?
Correct.
Now, that black book that was
mm-hmm.
brought here tonight,
mm-hmm.
those incidents here are in that black book?
They should be.
Okay.
I believe they should be.
Okay. So the majority of the incidents in that black book against the Jet Set restaurant are based upon your 6-year investigation of the Jet Set restaurant?
That's not investigating. Sir, that's not what he said, and that's twisting what he said. And you're welcome to cross-examine him, certainly, about what he's produced here. But when you say he had a 6-year investigation, that's not what he testified to. What he testified to is he's lived across from the Jet Set restaurant. He's observed things. When he felt it warranted a call to the police, he did that.
Mr. Chairman, I disagree
again,
with you.
Again, I'm the solicitor, I'm not the chairman. But if you want to say what he did was an investigation, you explain to us why it's an investigation when he presents facts that happened in front of his house. If you want to say that he came up here and got a report, that's an investigation. If he went online and downloaded pictures from the Jet Set Facebook page and the Jet Set whatever other page, that's an investigation, fine. We'll call that an investigation. But let's get to the point about what you want him to testify to. If you want him to repeat that he got a report from the police department, we can do that. But it's already been asked and answered.
Well, I look at it a little bit differently, Mr. Solicitor. I look at it as I've been representing these people, and all they had is complaints from this individual over a period of 6 years.
Well, that's not what the testimony was tonight. The testimony by Captain Tornelli was that most of the complaints came from officers on the site, that citizens also made complaints. And if you want, in closing or in cross, to say you won't testify to how many calls that you made to the department, and you want the board to infer that he is the primary instigator of the calls, that's fine. I think we all understand that's where you're going. But why don't we get there?
Well, the way I look at it is this. This man is set out for a period of 6 years with a vendetta against the Jet Set restaurant and never been in the Jet Set restaurant. Is that correct?
Yes, I have.
You have?
When they first opened up, I ate there.
Okay,
and that's a perfect thing for you to do in closing. But you're not testifying now. So if you want to ask him questions about the documents that he's produced and where he got them, that's great.
You got these documents from the police department?
That's correct.
When did you get these documents?
Possibly 4 days ago, 2 or 3 days ago. I'm not sure.
Okay. But now, the remaining exhibits that you presented here tonight, how long did it take you to accumulate those exhibits?
Well, some I had already because I've been before the zoning board before, so I had some of those already. Again, when you say a personal vendetta, it is more of if you lived and your neighbor was constantly coming in your property and pooping, and over the years of time, you would call the police, and every time you went before the person who finds the neighbor, would you say, that person has a personal vendetta against me because my dog is pooping on my yard? No. It's because incidents that are taking place, you are seeing what's happening, and you are concerned. Again, I'm concerned for myself, my family, and the community. And not only that, even for them, their own safety. I grew up in New York, okay? I'm an ex-drug addict. I know the game, all right? I work with the state police, probation, county probation, state parole, or law enforcement.
Have you, in the city of Reading, made inspections or investigations of other bars and restaurants?
I didn't even make an investigation against Jesset.
Well, I'll show you what's marked as Exhibit 6. And that consists of 37 signatures of people living in the neighborhood,
mm-hmm.
okay, that have testified, or a statement of, mm-hmm. that they respect everything that was done by Mr. Abreu. Mm-hmm. How do you offer explanations? Did you contact any of these people?
No.
Why not?
I didn't go around getting signatures. I didn't feel like I needed to. I felt that what I have is sufficient, and what was going to be being said tonight with reports as far as from the police department and what's going to be said tonight would be more than sufficient. When you live there, and I live, and I've seen the incidents that have taken place and how it affects the community and the safety of the community and Reading as a whole, I'm concerned. I'm into helping people. I'm not into bringing down people. That's why I said I have nothing against Mr. Jonathan, his father, his family, or the business.
What prompted you to do all these reports?
When it comes.
What prompted you to do all these reports? There are 37 signatures here, mm-hmm. with the addresses within a 2-block radius. Mm-hmm. And none of these people here, okay, you have discussed this with, mm-hmm. when they're supporting Mr. Abreu, mm-hmm. nothing like this could happen?
No.
Why?
I didn't feel the need to.
You didn't feel the need to?
I'm here to report what happened with me and what has taken place that I have viewed and I have seen.
Over a period of 6 years?
Over a period of 6 years.
And over a period of 6 years, you made calls to the police department?
I'm sorry?
You made calls to the police department?
I made some calls to the police
department. About how many would you say?
I have no idea.
You have no idea?
No.
Well, you took the time out to get the witnesses. You took mm-hmm. the time out to get the 6-year period of the mm-hmm. police department. You mean you didn't even check that book, that black book?
I don't have access to that book.
Did you ask?
No, I didn't even know that it existed the same way. I didn't know that this is 60.
I see. How many reports have you made to the Reading Police Department about the jets at restaurant?
I have no idea.
Did right. you keep a record?
No. Sir, that's about the 10th time you've asked that question, and he said he doesn't know. Okay?
Well,
so, I mean, you can if you ask it 11 times, he's going to say, I don't know. And let's cut to the chase here.
Well, the chase is this man has spent 6 years.
And that's a great thing to bring up in closing. But if you want to ask him the questions, ask him. And ask him, after he's answered them, then don't ask him the same question again.
Okay.
All right?
One last question. Mm-hmm. Okay, you've been living in this neighborhood for how long?
24 years.
And during that period of the last 10 years, have you talked to any of the individuals in the neighborhood that have offered any complaints against the Jet Set restaurant?
I'm sorry, repeat that question.
Have you mm-hmm. talked to any people in the neighborhood whose names appear in this list about any complaints they had about the Jet Set restaurant?
Yes, the one lady that stood up, I know her as Chela. When they first opened up, even though she spoke on behalf of Mr. Jonathan, when they first opened up, she was constantly coming to me, and we would talk in the neighborhood and say, I can't stand that place, there's no parking, there's fights, and there's craziness. What has changed her heart or changed her mind? I don't know.
Well, have you ever talked to any of these people on this exhibit list?
No, I don't. Why? I don't know who they are. So
well,
that's what I said. I don't know them by names.
You don't know them by names? Mm-hmm. They happen to be your neighbors.
Okay.
You talk to any of your neighbors?
I talk to all my neighbors.
And have they ever offered any complaints that you have?
Yes.
And do you have the names of those witnesses that...
I can have them accessible.
Well, why don't you have them presented tonight?
Because when the zoning... things went up, I didn't have enough time between working and whatever time I had, I tried to gather whatever I could from what I had already and everything. There are people who are living there. One is dealing with cancer. She was not able to come. The other one has health issues, who lives right across the street from Jet Set, was not able to come.
We need that exhibit 6. That's yeah. that's a
right.
official exhibit.
The names. I'm just trying to separate. Okay.
All right, thank you.
One last question, okay? Are you saying that you would have no problem if the Jets Head restaurant would continue to operate, but they had to modify what they operate?
No.
What are you saying?
What I'm saying is I don't have a problem with them operating as a restaurant and only catering parties.
Okay.
Because the so-called parties, quote-unquote, that Mr. Jonathan said, was only for bands and so on like that. And as you see from the exhibit, it wasn't that. And that only creates atmospheres like that. Why do they have to, again, look at the videos. If you can have access, you can go on YouTube, where you see security guards have to be around the girls who are dancing in these little things here and stuff like that to protect them.
Well, you
them.
Haven't been in here to see that, have you?
No.
Why not?
That's not my style of entertainment.
But your style of investigation is behind the scenes.
No. I didn't do an investigation. I don't know what you're talking about.
Have you investigated any bar or restaurant in the city?
Again, this is a repeated question. So let's get moving forward here, all right? Okay. We understand what your point is, sir. We understand that you're trying to vigorously represent your client. But when the same question is asked, probably upwards of 10 times, then we're going to cut it off. All right?
I understand. One last question.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You said that 5 times already. Okay.
Have you any information whatsoever, okay, from the police department that you produced tonight? How did you get this information?
I stated that already.
Would you mind repeating it, because there's a book
there. I went to the police department window, and they told me where to go, right across the other window, to be able to get information regarding calls.
Well, I would describe, would it be accurate to say that you're a vigilante, but the only one you've concentrated on?
All right, that's enough. We've had it. All right. You've made that point. You've been abusive now to the witness. If you want to say those things in closing, that's fine. But we're not going to tolerate it anymore. Do I make myself clear? Please understand that. I'm telling you.
And please understand our respect for this board.
And that's fine, but when you ask the same question, I don't represent the city. I represent and advise the zoning board. And they have been very tolerant with you having repeated questions over and over and over again tonight. Now, if you have any more questions for him, ask them in a civil manner. If you want to impugn his character in closing, feel free to do it. But we're not going to do it right now. So do you have any more questions for the witness?
I have no more questions, but I also like to point out something very important. Well, I'm representing a client.
You can do that in closing, sir.
If any witnesses other than this gentleman here who's carrying out a 6-year vendetta.
All right, stop it. This is closing, and you're starting to now testify, and you're going to run into a very, very thin spotch of ice very shortly, sir. So please refrain from this type of behavior, and let's conduct ourselves as attorneys and gentlemen. Do you have any more questions for him?
No.
All right. Does anybody in the audience have any questions for this witness? Yes, Mr. Ricketts.
I apologize for not wasting much of your time. The first question is, how many houses are on the block?
Yes. It can be 20, 30?
64.
Okay.
Of all the neighbors, because I know they have some issues here, out of all the neighbors, how many people have complained about that system to you? Or you have inquired information?
I haven't inquired. I have come to my... I brought it to my attention. Well, when you talk about having how many units, how many houses you said they were there?
There are 65.
Okay, how many of them are homeowners?
What's the exact number? 63.
Okay, 63. How many of them are homeowners?
Let me answer how many homes are there.
Okay.
63.
All right.
How many people have sent you a complaint about this? Okay. Or you've asked in the neighborhood?
I haven't asked. They've come in and spoken to me. I would say probably about 14, 15.
Okay. And are any of them here besides your family?
Yes, Mr. Juan here.
Just one person?
There was two, but she had to leave, yes.
Okay, so two people were here. Mm-hmm. Out of 65 homes. Mm-hmm.
65 homes.
63 homes.
Okay.
Earlier, I just want to clarify one thing, not an attorney, but when you said that officer or captain said there were a majority of the calls were made from or generated from JetSet, he cannot make that statement because he didn't require the exact numbers of what calls were made by the city cops or anyone else that called it.
We have the testimony, and it's transcribed, and I think...
No, I understand. He did say that, but then you can't say something where you don't have to fact the numbers.
That's
what he said. Second thing is, when he... Junior, you said you don't have a personal vendetta against JetSet, mm-hmm. correct? Okay. Definition of vendetta, a prolonged bitter core or a campaign against someone. Definition of vendetta. You spent 6 years reporting information against one person, one company, one business, one entity. That isn't considered a vendetta. When you spend that much time videotaping, which most people have stalked.
It's not videotaping, guys.
You said from your place?
From my place, that's right. I'm straight out of work.
Okay, so from the place you work or your place?
My place and work, straight out of work.
Your workplace gave you those videos?
Yes. I run those cameras.
Do we have any?
Sorry, did you say I run those cameras?
Whatever, they're in the, where I work, I'm supposed to survey anything, so if any incidents happen with the resident, and if I, so if I see something that's out of the residence, out of the residence, like an incident, people come to me, say, Junior, my car got broken into last night, can you please look at the video to see if you can see somebody who broke into my car, or, and so on like that, so, yeah, so if an incident happens, I can go back to the recording to review what took place.
The question is, with all the videotapes and evidence of the alleged assaults and shootings, have you provided the police plans for investigations?
Almost all of them, yes.
Yeah, and has anything happened with those?
You would have to ask, you would have to ask them.
All right, I'll.
Thank you, Mr. Riggs. All right, yes, Mr. Teo.
I really don't want to come up here again. I know long.
But you're here.
Yeah. I would actually to the board, and everybody understand that you mentioned my name to remove the sign. Mm-hmm. Mr. Craig already know.
Question. This is a question. Do you have a question?
Okay. Sorry. And I make a, my engineer make a plan for the parking lot. I work with PennDOT department almost 3 years.
Okay.
Very difficult question.
Do you have a question for this witness? You're not testifying now.
Okay.
Do you have a question for him?
How can I claim? Yeah, because he told me I removed a sign illegal.
He said that he has a picture of you removing a sign.
That's right, but I want to explain to the board why I removed the sign.
Well, then you can ask him the question. Do you know why I removed the sign?
Why I do that?
The signs could not be there. My understanding, the signs could not be there in order for PennDOT.
Yes.
Is that correct?
No. Yeah.
Why did you remove it?
Why? Yeah. I invite PennDOT engineer come with the marker.
Okay, sir. Please. Just ask him. You asked him. Does he know why you removed the sign? And he told you why he believes you removed the sign. If that's correct or incorrect, that's for the board to determine. Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Okay. And also one. Before. I invite Mr. Raphael. You ask me who come into the building to visit. I say he from New York, Dominican. You told me you hate Dominican people.
I never said
that. Yeah, you say that. Now, you lucky, you work with the church. Mm-hmm. You eat the food from the church. Mm-hmm. I don't think you pay any tax.
Do you want to ask him a question?
Now,
sir,
you let me.
All right, stop.
I'm sorry.
You can ask questions, but you're not going to testify again.
Okay.
So would you please ask a question?
Do you pay any city tax, property tax? Is city ready?
It's a ministry's tax exempt. It's called a parachurch ministry.
You let me. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you.
All right. Do you have any more questions for Mr.?
I know, I don't. But I'd like to.
Wait, hold on. All right. Well, no, hold on. Your name is Angel Sarge?
Yes.
S-A-R-G-E?
Yes.
And where do you reside, sir?
I live in Mount Penn.
No, sir,
I've been listening to this whole thing.
Sir, you will not participate.
First of all, he's not having his cameras faced towards the restaurant.
Sir, you're
and
not.
Second of all, you and him are biased.
I'm not biased, sir. Yes, I'm just trying to keep control of the hearing, sir.
You are two-faced.
Okay, thank you, sir. All right, do you have any other questions? Okay. All right. Does anybody else want to testify against this application? The record will reflect that nobody wants to testify against this application. There's no further testimony.
Well, I'm sorry, Mr. Solicitor, a rebuttal?
You want to have a rebuttal witness to him?
A brief rebuttal by myself.
Sure.
Okay.
You're going to, wait, no, you want to close or you want to have another witness? To rebut that testimony.
Well, we have a lot of witnesses here, okay, and I haven't seen one witness in the neighborhood that's present today or signed which substantiates the evidence.
Let's do this. Do you have another witness to rebut his testimony, or do you feel that you don't need to do that, that you'll do that in closing?
I would do that in closing.
All right. So with that, the evidentiary portion of this hearing is completed. The exhibits by all the participants will be admitted into evidence. This packet from the last witness will have to be marked as exhibit number 8. Everybody's been provided by all the participants with copies of the exhibits. With that, then, we'll turn it back over to you, sir, and you may make your closing to the board.
Mr. Solicitor, members of the panel, I'm here to defend a person, a family, who for the past 6 years have been working very hard to establish a business in the city of Reading. And the type of business they have, you know, of course, is entertainment, bar, and restaurant. Now, that doesn't make them, you know, guilty of any crime, okay, when you consider all the bars and restaurants that are in the city of Reading, okay? Now, in the city of Reading, okay, I hate to say this, but there's a source or lack of revenue coming into the city. Now, we have three members of a family, okay, who've been operating a Jet Set restaurant for 6 years. And it isn't easy to do that, but they've tried very, very hard. But for every person in that neighborhood from 2 blocks radius have not come forward to make one accusation against the Jet Set restaurant. This is a one-man vendetta, okay? For whatever reason, I do not know. I'm not that smart, nor am I that wise. But the combined, you know, talent of the gentlemen here have heard these cases before, okay, something is very awkward here. It's a one man testifies with unbelievable amount of evidence, which indicates to me a persecution complex. Here's a gentleman who runs a halfway house across the street. He pays no taxes, and it seems like he is dedicated, okay, by saying, well, I have no objection to the Jet Set restaurant, but I do have a Jet Set restaurant complaint, okay, of serving bar alcohol. The Jet Set restaurant cannot survive on a restaurant only because there are no more people coming in to the restaurant. What's at stake here, okay, is that this is a family that has worked very hard for 6 years. Mistakes have been made. But I would infer from the evidence that's been presented to the board, and I appreciate the board, okay, listening, okay, to how we presented our case. But that binder and these documents are the evidence of one man. One man who has assisted the police and produced that particular booklet. One man has presented 8 exhibits that are outrageous. Where the photographs were, he's never been in the Jet Set restaurant. He's never been there because the client I have here would know who he is because they've been there watching him for 6 years. And for 6 years, this man has carried out a vendetta, okay? No other complaints, okay, by any neighbor has come into this chamber to testify, just one. And of course, the lady with him. I would suggest that there's something here that the board must consider. I don't mean must consider because I'm requesting that you consider that this is a one-man show. Okay, and that witness has a vendetta by the nature of the evidence that's been submitted. And I would urge this panel to consider that this is a family, okay, that's worked very hard for 6 years. They came here, they spent hundreds of thousands of dollars to build a restaurant. While a lot of businesses are closing down in Reading, and a lot of people are out of work, okay, this family here has been able to hire people to work in the city, okay, to make a living for the city. And if the pattern here is one man could bring down the Jet Set restaurant, okay, then other parties in this city were also going to be brought down. This is an economic issue as well, okay? I know this family very, very well, and I wouldn't come here with such a vigorous attitude unless I believe them and support them, and that's why I'm here. And if I sound like I'm winded, it's because I feel for this family that one man, with all this evidence, the police reports, and the reports that he's presented, and the efforts he's going through, is a vendetta. It's actually a vendetta. If this board satisfied that one man can conduct that investigation, okay, when there isn't any other person in this room or in this city has made any claim challenging the good nature of the Rafaela Booth family, okay? And I'm emphasizing that, and I'm sorry if I'm taking too long, but this is an important issue, because a family's business in Reading, okay, is on the verge of being destroyed. And if you destroy this family, you'll destroy others. And that's why Reading has to pull itself together and have groups like the Jet Set Restaurant to bring people into the city and to make an existence. And I don't believe that this panel should take the evidence of one man as against 37 people who signed those petitions. One man for 6 years has conducted a vendetta against the Jet Set. People have come here in support of the Jet Set Restaurant. And I'd ask you to please consider that, okay, in your deliberations, okay, because you all experienced men, you've been through life, and I feel as though one man should not take the position to destroy an entire family and an entire business without having reasons of his own, a vendetta, for 6 years. And the police reports are filled with his complaints that make it seem like the police department is working overtime because of the inhabitants of going in there. There's not been one evidence presented of any improper conduct inside the Jet Set Restaurant. There were conclusions of information in that black book put together by one man. And if one man can stand out against 37 neighbors who live in the same neighborhood, who live here in Reading, participate and work hard, then you're destroying the whole caliber of the city of Reading. And I believe if you would consider that that testimony by itself should not be upheld by this board because of your age and your experience and your knowledge. I believe it's a vendetta, and if there's a vendetta by him, all people will be subject to that. And I appreciate your patience and your time, but I feel very strongly for this case, and I feel very strongly for this family. And if I was out of line, I apologize, and I appreciate the solicitor allowing me to make this speech. You gentlemen have not in any way interfered with my presentation because I'm defending a client and friend.
Thank you, sir. As you know, the board does not render decisions the night of the hearing, especially something that has this much testimony and obviously community interest in, and we appreciate every member of the community on whatever side you took in participating tonight. The board will render a written decision at next month's hearing, which is the second Wednesday of the month. And what date is that? It is the 9th, because election day is Tuesday, right? So it's it'll be Wednesday the 9th of November. You do not need to be present. If you're not present, a copy will be mailed to your solicitor or to your attorney and to you, Mr. Abreu, okay?
Thank you.
All right. Thank you again for participating. Have a good evening. All right, we have four decisions to render here.
We have some decisions.
Okay, mark that as 8.
I wanted to wait until they quiet down a little bit too. No, that's all right. Anytime, Holly.
I understand. And your place in a week, part of our job,
yeah, thank you.
As you know, is to support what right. We were trying to give the benefit of the doubt. I was just talking I was going to ask.
Yeah, you can have one.
What was your reaction?
I don't know why. That's to, right. Thank you.
Questions about.
Oh, okay.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, we have to render decisions. All right. If we can have order, because we have to render some decisions, please.
We have to finish this. Anyway,
we need those.
That's what I wanted to say.
Yep.
Be good.
Okay.
Thank you. Be good.
I'll start. All right, folks, we have to render some decisions. So if you want to have conversations, please go out to the hallway. Thank you, and or sit down because the camera is trying to film. All right, Mr. Chairman, you have appeal number 2016. Is there a motion to approve the relief requested subject to the conditions set forth in the written decision?
Motion to approve.
Second.
Any questions or comments on the motion? All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Ayes have it. With respect to appeal number 2016-27, is there a motion to approve the requested relief subject to the conditions set forth in the written decision?
Make a motion.
Second.
Any questions or comments on the motion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Ayes have it. With respect to appeal number 2016-28, is there a motion to approve the relief requested subject to the conditions set forth in the written decision?
Motion to approve.
Second.
Any questions or comments on the motion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Ayes have it. With respect to appeal number 2016-29, is there a motion to approve the relief requested subject to the conditions set forth in the written decision?
Motion to approve.
Second.
Any questions or comments on the motion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Ayes have it. Mr. Chairman?
All right. That concludes our meeting for the month of October. Thank you for being here.